Hi, my name is Dev Empath and welcome to a Blender tutorial. We'll be going through the ocean modifier. I'll also be showing you the foam setting and how you set that up, because you actually need to do that with nodes. It's not as simple as I'm sure you found. You can't just tick foam and bam, there's foam. There's a bit to it. So let's get started. Basically, in 2.9, you can start with your default cube, but in earlier versions, you couldn't. So what we're going to do is we're going to cater for everyone. So what we're going to do is delete that default cube. Add a plane. If you're in 2.9, you do not need to add a plane at all. You can just add the ocean modifier. But earlier versions of Blender, you had to add a plane. You'll see in a second, right? Now, once you've added your new plane, add the ocean modifier, boom, which does this. It doesn't really look like an ocean, but it's getting there. It's wavy. Now what we're going to do is we're just going to bust open all of these settings. See, we enabled foam, nothing happened, as we expected. Then we're going to add a new material to this. Now if you did this with a default cube, there will already be a material here, but we're going to add a new one and ensure that this use nodes is selected. So if it's not selected, it kind of looks like that. You can see it's like gray, and selected is blue, and you can kind of see the rest of these pop in here. So now once we've done that, we're off to the shading tab. The shading tab, you'll see not much changes here. Now ocean color, this is our base color. Right, so this we can change to anything. You can pretty much have whatever ocean color you want, but in reality the ocean is actually pretty dark, so we're going to go for around there and a sort of darkish color. I mean, we can tweak this value later. Then what we're going to need to add is an attribute node. Pop that over there. We're going to need a emission node. We'll pop that over there. And then basically to add this all together, we're going to need an add shader. Now I'm going to pop the add shader into here just so that you can see that nothing has changed yet. But I'm going to connect this up to here and connect this emission up to this shader. Also, not much has changed. Still not an ocean. Now in this attribute, you need to name this attribute foam or foamy, whatever the hell you want to name it. But you got to remember this name. Now we're going to go back to the modifier settings, and in this data layer, we're going to type the same thing we just typed, which is foamy, and voila, sort of very bad looking ocean, I'm sure you will agree. First things first, I'm going to show you what resolution does. Now, I think you'll agree this is not the greatest of oceans in the world, but as I slowly tick up resolution here, there's 8, there's 9, there's 10. In fact, I'm actually going to just give it a slow drag. You can kind of see that it just gets more and more and more detailed. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you, if you just look at this difference, this is the difference between 7 and 50. Give it a moment to render there, but 50 is quite beefy. Probably your average setting that you would be using just to kind of experiment with it probably be around the 25 to 30 range, but as you can see, this 50 looks very, very good. So basically we go back to 15 just so that I'm sure you can see the difference there in the frame rate of the capture. But simple enough, that's resolution, obviously the better. Now the next thing that's actually important is scale. So scale, you kind of want to start off at 2. This basically makes the waves more wavy. I'll drag it up slowly here for you, and you can kind of see that they eventually it kind of just gets ridiculous. But having said that, there are cases in where you would need probably at least a 7 or an 8. In really rough seas, you would need, you know, potentially something hectic. But for our cases, I would recommend either a 3 or a 2.5 just for a little something there. One thing we never did is we never changed the material. What we'll do here is for roughness, we'll go down to 0.1. You can really kind of do whatever you want here. This takes a bit more experimenting than me just giving you details. So really, I would say, you know, start at 0.1, take it as 0, see what it looks like. Do you like what it looks like? Do you not? Transmission, just so you know, water is reflective. So we've got to make this reflective. And basically, for our rendering shot, we'll probably use 25, just because, meh. And then I'm just going to drag this up so that you don't see the grid. Click to set it, and there we go. And that's how you make an ocean in Blender. Leave a like if this was useful to you, and have a great day.